your panels and also your path. So window layer should be open and window path should be open. If they're keep pulling off the screen, you can have multiple tabs. Otherwise, you're only allowed to open one at a time. So you just drag them off to have multiple. That one I don't require, so I'm just gonna close that. But I will need my layer and I need my path. Okay. This little box we need to get rid of. So we right-click the text and rasterize the layer. So now we can actually start editing this picture. This is your path tool. We're going to create a clipping path that we can use over and over again every time we add a picture. It's almost like a frame mask, and anything outside of that won't be used. So we are using our friend the pen tool, which is hiding somewhere in my docket. Hello, pen tool, there it is. Okay, pen tool. And you'll notice it's called a path, not a pen tool, because it's creating a frame that we follow. So it works the same way as the Illustrator pen tool in terms of clicking and holding to create a curve. If you find that you're ever stuck and it creates like a wonky curve like that, you just click the last handlebar once with Alt. So hold Alt and click, and it will allow you to, hello, there's my Alt. It'll allow you to release the handlebar Alt, and then you'll be able to make a new curve based on that. Spend your time, zoom in, go really slow. For this purpose, I'm gonna go really fast because I'm not sure if you'd like to watch me do this very slowly. It might be a little bit tedious for you. So I'm gonna try and go a little bit faster and create just a rough outline of myself, and you'll see the purpose. And then for future tutorials, I'll make sure I have a really nice, good one. But for the purpose of this activity, you'll notice that over here, as you're going, the work path is whoop, whoop, undo. You can go back a couple if you need to, because that was a really big handlebar. You really need to release that. You'll notice that as you're going, again, the path is being created. And at the very end, you'll have a closed shape. So when you get to the very end, which I'm going to go really fast there, Alt click, you'll have a closed shape. That shape will always stay there. So anytime you add an image, you can select that shape. And if you think you did a really good job tracing, have a 0 feather radius. If you're like, I'm not so good, have a 3 feather radius. It will bring up the marching ants. And from there, you can copy and paste yourself out of the graphic. And as you see, I can zoom in for tracing, but you'll have just yourself. Now that I've copied and pasted, though, that image is still there. And why that's really important is anytime I bring in a secondary picture, so for example, a photo I'm going to overlay on top, I can bring that picture wherever I plan on placing the picture, and that path is still available to me. So it pops up again every time I require it, and I'm able to again make the selection and again copy and paste, and it creates just that thing. If you want it to paste right over top, make sure you hold shift and it will paste in place. And then you'll see I have just that following the same frame. We'll talk about how it overlays and adding dissolves in the next video, but just so you can see that that work path will always stay relevant. So make sure you actually spend a lot of time zooming in and slowly going through your work path.